Rivers navigate our daily lives. The waterways, used as landmarks by native peoples and explored by early settlers, became the highways that brought hundreds of thousands of people to Colorado and the American West. These new arrivals found that whenever they strayed from fresh water sources, they became lost, thirsty, and distressed. Some continued on their westward journey. More than a handful decided to end their travels here. People who once hungered for gold found the Rocky Mountains also held the key for what every prospector and farmer needs: water. Even then, settlers dreamt of plenty and looked beyond the Continental Divide to the surplus waters of the West Slope. Today, more than 80% of our water supply originates on the West Slope, yet about 85% of Colorado's population lives along the Front Range on the state's East Slope. In a land once labeled the Great American Desert, Coloradans have learned through droughts and floods to be efficient with their water supplies. They have built the core structures to supplement what Mother Nature provides to almost 6 million people who now call Colorado home. The state is a diverse playground made up of flourishing urban areas, uninterrupted open spaces, scenic alpine roads, and quaint rural towns steeped in history. The Northern Colorado Water Conservancy District, known as Northern Water, was created in 1937 to help bring about one of the largest trans-mountain water diversion projects in American history, the Colorado-Big Thompson Project. Northern Water administers, operates, maintains, and funds this project in conjunction with its federal partner, the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation. This project is designed to collect and store water from the melting snowpack near the headwaters of the Colorado River and bring it underneath the Continental Divide. As this water reaches northeastern Colorado, Northern Water distributes it through an elaborate system of reservoirs, canals, and tunnels to its 8-county service area. The Colorado Big Thompson Project provides supplemental water to nearly 1 million residents and more than 640,000 acres of some of the most productive irrigated farmland in the United States. Northern Water's mission is rather simple: deliver supplemental water to a 1.5 million acre service area while providing water resources management and conservation services to water users. 33 municipalities receive a portion of their water supply from the project, along with 120 ditch, reservoir, and irrigation companies. Many businesses and industries have opened shop along the Northern Front Range over the past few decades and receive their supplies through the project. The project is simple in concept, but complex in design. Let's take a closer look at how the system works. The Colorado Big Thompson Project took 20 years to build and cost about $160 million, a bargain by today's standards. In order to put this gigantic jigsaw puzzle together, project engineers worked atop mountain peaks, in deep valleys, and along dry plains to bring together a western slope river basin, a large diversion tunnel under the Continental Divide, foothills reservoirs, and finally, an elaborate system of delivery pipelines and canals. Well before the project's inception, West Slope leaders also saw how water resources would be useful for industrial and irrigation expansion within the Colorado River Basin. To benefit West Slope users of the CBT project, Reclamation built Green Mountain Reservoir on the Blue River to provide water storage for the needs of Western Colorado. Perhaps the project's most impressive feature is the 13.1-mile-long Alva B. Adams Tunnel, which carries water underneath the Continental Divide. Builders of the tunnel captured the nation's imagination in 1944, when crews digging from each side met in the middle, more than 2,000 feet underneath the tundra of Rocky Mountain National Park. The CBT project also generates hydroelectricity, as its water descends about 2,500 feet from the east portal of the Adams Tunnel to the Front Range, passing through 5 power plants. This power reimbursed the federal government for the project's construction and operating costs, along with providing a clean, renewable supply of power for industries and communities throughout northeastern Colorado and the western United States. Runoff from the headwaters of the Colorado River Basin is stored behind Granby Dam, forming Lake Granby, the state's second largest body of water. This reservoir also stores water pumped through a canal from Willow Creek Reservoir to the west. Northern Water operates Granby Dam, helping to maintain minimum stream flows for fish in the Colorado River below the lake. From Lake Granby, the water is lifted by the Far Pump Plant into the Granby Pump Canal, feeding Shadow Mountain Reservoir. This reservoir, sitting at the same elevation as Grand Lake and connected to it by way of a small channel, ensures Grand Lake always remains at a steady elevation. Water flows by gravity from Grand Lake through the Adams Tunnel to the east slope, passing through a series of conduits, siphons, tunnels, penstocks, and power plants on its journey to water users throughout northeastern Colorado. Finally, water is stored in several reservoirs along the foothills, including Carter Lake, Horsetooth, and Boulder reservoirs. Water is released from these reservoirs through a series of canals or pipelines into creeks, rivers, or directly to water treatment plants. From there, water is diverted into customer irrigation canal systems or reservoirs for delivery to farmlands, cities, and businesses. The entire Colorado-Big Thompson Project operates in accord with seasonal changes and water user needs. Lake Granby acts as a savings account and is filled during the late spring and summer months as the winter snow melts. West Slope reservoirs send their water east during fall, winter, and early spring, making room for the next year's runoff. East Slope reservoirs are refilled before demand grows in the spring and summer. In addition to storing water for Front Range users, Colorado-Big Thompson Project reservoirs on both sides of the divide attract boaters, fishermen, and outdoor enthusiasts alike. Colorado's booming recreation economy generates tax dollars and contributes many direct jobs. It's no surprise that high-quality outdoor recreation is the reason many choose to live and play here. As Colorado's Front Range population continues to grow and the uncertainties of climate change unfold, the combination of the Colorado-Big Thompson Project, proposed water storage projects, and diligent conservation efforts will help to meet the needs for a reliable, clean water supply into the future. Water remains a vital part of the American West. The Colorado-Big Thompson Project will continue to support its heritage, economy, and beauty for generations to come.